From Washington, I am Robert Christian. Today, in the first hour of today's show, Regina Cates. We're going to be talking with her about Global Pride, a true celebration. And, of course, her book that she has. Lead with your heart. The book, the author. Of course, it is on Amazon, Barnes & Noble, as she has so told me prior to the show. In an hour or two, this is going to be a hot topic. Because guess what? The masses have spoken, ladies and gentlemen. So tune in and crank it up. We're going to be taking a look at what is wrong with mainstream media. And when it comes to gay and lesbian issues, why is it that it is a political ploy and not the realistic news that people want to hear on mainstream media? We're going to be getting into that. First, let's take a look at the headlines. A bill introduced in Congress this week by Nancy Pelosi and other members pushed for the equality for members of the LGBT community is getting support from the tech giant Apple. The LGBT Equality Act, introduced this week, would amend the Civil Rights Act of 1964 by extending those rights of freedom from discrimination to the LGBT community. Like it or not, it's on the way. Jeb Bush is also making his news. Jeb Bush under fire from Democrats, goody goody, for saying that he would phase out Medicare. He also, he said a few other things, but he wanted to put his blame and his pigeonhole here on Medicare and wanting to phase it out as if that's really going to solve the issue. Well, Mr. Jeb Bush, I have a word for you. Contact me if you've got the comeuppance and we'll have a conversation about it. Nonetheless, in other news, he continued to speak and he just won't quit. Same-sex couples can finally get married everywhere in the country thanks to the U.S. Supreme Court's long-awaited ruling last month. A couple can exchange rings, dance the night away, and then post pictures of the event on Facebook. True, just like any other couple. Oh, but wait. Now comes the dark shadow. But because their boss could find the photos on Monday, realize that that they are gay and fire them because they're gay. Do you know that there are states that have laws that say, hey, you can discriminate against these people if you don't like them. You can fire them just because they're gay. How would you like that? It's true. What is this other little news item? A church in Georgia has been vandalized with Bible verses weeks after the marriage of its gay pastor. Burn, Leviticus 18:22, lies and you will burn, was written in white spray paint on the front doors of the steps of the Metropolitan Community Church of Our Redeemer in Augusta, Georgia. The Bible verse condemns gay sex and says it is an abomination. Old Testament. Folks, I am Robert Christian. We're going to be right back. Don't go away with our featured guest today, Regina Cates. It's going to be a fun interview and one you don't want to miss. Here we go. Live from Seattle, The Robert Christian Show, and online, robertchristianshow.com. We encourage you to move the masses, one person at a time. Like progressive talk radio and talk shows, you found the right place. And we are thrilled today, ladies and gentlemen, to have you aboard with us. And because you are with us, you know what? I am going to not delay with getting and introducing our featured guest. Hello, Regina.
Hello, Robert.
You know, we were talking just prior to the show actually starting, and We share so much in common, it's ridiculous, I think.
Well, actually, I think.
You know, it is, and you know, I tell you, that it's not often that you find people that click, I mean, immediately. And there was something about you, when I first heard about you, that I thought, you know, wait a second, I really need to get this, get Regina. I need to get her on, and see what's going on. So how has your life changed?
Since when, Robert?
since yesterday. Since same-sex marriage became legal in the United States.
You know, Robert, to be honest with you, my life has not changed at all. It really has not. I held fast that this was always going to be the will of the people. This was always going to be the will of what was going to happen. And I was just waiting for that particular opportunity. I think we're all blessed. And I think we still have some challenges in education. So we're not finished.
No, absolutely not. You know, I look at the news headlines, and especially out of Kentucky. The state of Kentucky, and because there for a long time, the governor was standing behind these agents that were not doing their job, and saying, "Good riddance, that's a good thing. Don't do your job, you don't have to marry same-sex couples." But now he's saying it's either you do or you're fired. So, yeah. Of all states, and then of course Alabama, I believe it is, the state of Alabama. Here they are in the Deep South. We were talking about the Deep South earlier, but here they are, and there are still 12 or 15 counties in that state that are refusing to accept what the U.S. Supreme Court has said. What do you think about all that?
Well, I think that, you know, we were talking about the Deep South because I am from the Deep South, and I have a lot of love for a lot of people in the Deep South, Robert. I really do. I lived in Birmingham, Alabama for 20 years, and Texas and Georgia and Missouri. So I'm very familiar with the thinking. I was raised in the Christian church and fundamentalist. So I understand what's going on. And you're talking about a deep-seated fear, a fear-based control issue. And it really goes beyond that, because if people start stop pointing the finger of blame at you and me, then they're going to have to actually look at themselves, and that is absolutely terrifying, because it's easier just to sit up there and let someone else shovel stuff into your mind rather than you actually thinking for yourself and having a true connection to the divine. A lot easier.
What do you think that, you know, I mean, looking back, when George Bush Jr. was the occupant in chief in the White House, when he was running for the second term, and this is really when I paid attention, because the Republican agenda back then was, vote for me, gay people will never get married, and we as a nation will remain at war. And it was a fear tactic. Do you think that it has worked for the Republican Party?
Absolutely not. No, it's not going to work for either party. It's not going to work for anyone in politics anymore, because we're too smart. You know, we're getting tired of sitting on the couch of apathy, Robert. Those of us, gay people, straight people, it doesn't matter. We are tired of being screamed, so to speak. I hope I can use that on your
show. Sure.
We really are, and I think it's time that we're educating ourselves. I think that it's time that we're moving into a new direction, and we have to continue to keep up that front. I'm not talking about a battle here, because I don't see it as a battle, because we're going to win. It's just a matter of time. And I think we have a certain way that we can approach this so that we come out smelling like a rose in all of this. And that's what all of my work is about. So, no, I don't think it's going to serve anybody to lambast another group. We can't operate like that and survive.
You know, I agree with you. We can't. The problem, though, that I see, Regina, is other groups, the far right wing religious knuckleheads, in our country, and here they are. I mean, again, I don't have any problem with anybody that practices their faith. That's their right. However, to use one's faith to abuse other people and or to judge them, that's unsightly. It shouldn't be done. But
well, it's also not correct, Robert, so I don't have a problem, you know, evaluating, because judgment is different. I don't have a problem evaluating that that's not aligned with divine, no matter how many religious texts you read that say that it is. I mean, all of this stuff is being interpreted in a way that serves those who want it to serve them. And in my business, Romancing Your Soul, I am a whole lot about the truth and establishing a clear relationship to whatever that divine is. It's not male, you know. It's not put into a box, and that's what organized religion does. It puts everything into a neat box, and if
right.
you don't fit into it, then you're, you know, doomed to hell or whatever. I just got back from a trip to the South where I sat in a Sunday school class and listened to the woman talk about how horrible homosexuals are. My father and my mother and my sister and brother-in-law were in that class. And after she got finished, my father said, "Do not judge, lest you be judged." My father's 91 years old, Robert. He's done 180 degrees because he challenged his beliefs in what that book says that was written in a time that is not even applicable to today. So we're dealing with something in the Deep South and with organized religion that is going to have to come from within, Robert. The change is going to have to come from within. And I see it. I see it happening very strongly. Yeah.
You know, I do too. And it's time that change does happen. I mean, we can look at some of these name brand preachers on television. Again, if that's their craft, if that's what they want, that's up to them. But to use the Almighty pulpit, which is supposed to be a place where hurting people can be healed and not destroyed, but they're
right.
using it as venom.
That's correct, and none of that is correct. And I think that's what the people of the United States and people within organized religion are seeing, because this doesn't align with love. You know, anything that has to do with God or whatever that concept is has to do with love. And if you're pointing the finger of blame, if you're judging, if you're ridiculing, if you're saying someone else is less than you or not equal to you, then that is not of the divine. That is of control. That is of fear. That is of a motivation that has nothing to do with what the message is.
No. So would you venture to say that the message within the modern day religious church, that it is a message based on fear or one that is based on love?
I don't think that we can generalize it that way, Robert. I think that what we can say is that there are a lot of people who are continuing to follow organized religion that are now understanding what the purpose of that is. I think that we have some that are still stuck in the dark ages, particularly in the South, only because I come from that particular experience and that's what I can talk about. But that's what I see. I see that we're having a division within Christianity. We're having a division within a lot of organized religions, because there are a certain aspect of these people that understand what spirituality is. And there are certain aspects of these people that want to cling to the ancient beliefs. So there's an internal conflict here.
So let me ask you this. And I asked, there was another pastor, Sid Andrews. I had her on from
yep.
Memphis not long ago. I don't know if you, do you know who she is?
I know who she is, yes. Uh-huh.
Okay, yep, I had her on. And I had asked her a very good question that was asked of me years ago. And the question is this: how can I, for that matter, justify my sexuality with my faith?
How can you justify your sexuality with your faith?
Yes.
That's the struggle that I wrote about in my book, to be honest with you, Robert, because God made me. This is a biological phenomenon, but science has proven that. So this is how I was made. I knew at the age of 3 years old that I was gay. I couldn't tell you how I knew I was gay, but, you know, we know these sorts of things. This is biological, just like if you were born straight. My sister was raised in the same house. She's straight, you know? So this
right.
is part of who I am, the makeup of who I am. Therefore, God made me. Therefore, God loves me. It took me a long time, Robert, to get to this particular place, because I had been beaten up so much by organized religion. Every time I walked into the church, you're going to hell. You're lesser than. You're choosing this. This is a lifestyle. What is my lifestyle, Robert? I pay taxes. I get up. I drink coffee. I mow my lawn. You know, I take care of other people's children. I love them. That's my lifestyle, Robert. It's loving. It's not whatever this gay lifestyle is that they've been programmed to fear.
Right. Well, I think that a lot of people fear things because to them it is the unknown. And it's unknown. If I can put a dollar's worth in here, it's because they continue to remain in a box. They're not breaking out of it.
Yeah, because they're comfortable in that box. However, they're not really comfortable in that box, Robert, because if they actually would think about how uncomfortable they really are, look, let me just be real honest here, because that's who I am anyway. I'm just going to speak it like it is. You've got a lot of really wounded people in church today, and you want to know why? Because the message, at least the ones that I have been exposed to, even recently, even in this last trip to Texas, is so depressive. It is so negative. It's about how you're not worthy. It's about how you'll never make it. What in the world is this? It's someone's, you know, distorted interpretation. This is all about love, Robert. You know, spirituality is all about love. So I have no problem being gay. I have no problem, aligning with the divine, because this is how I was made. But I tell you what I have a problem with is people who will not look outside of that box to seek truth, to seek fact, and to actually care how their beliefs are so negative and impact other people. You know?
So how can you, and you know, you're opening up Pandora's box.
Excellent. I love it.
But how can you, how can anybody that is in the gay and lesbian community at large, how can we be so versed where we can enlighten other people to not to see things our way, but rather to see things for the truth that it really is?
Well, Robert, I think that we're all here, regardless if we're gay, straight, transgender, any of that. We're all here to have some sort of relationship, personal relationship with something greater than ourselves. So in my work every single day, I don't care if you're gay, I don't care if you're black, white, straight, whatever. I am devoted to helping us master a mind that has a mind of its own, push ego aside so that we actually have a connection with that part of us that goes beyond gender, that goes beyond sexuality. When we lead with our heart, when we romance our soul, then we can be a perfect example, or a very good example, because nobody's perfect, of what true love looks like, whether we're gay, straight, whatever, it doesn't matter. That's the goal. It's the relationships that we create, Robert, with everyone.
You know, I do concur. I agree. The sad fact is that a lot of people will, a lot of family members, maybe some of our viewers, some of our podcast listeners, know people like this in your own families, and they will say, oh, this is my son, this is my brother. Okay, that's lovely. Some will say, oh, this is my gay brother.
Yeah.
This is my gay sister. This is what they're about.
Mm-hmm.
But they put the term gay or lesbian, this is my bisexual brother. They put the issue of that person's sexuality
mm-hmm.
on the table, on the shingle, before they even address them as a person.
That's right. And that's what we all have to work toward, Robert, because I don't have black friends, I have friends. I don't have Jewish friends, I have friends. I don't have gay friends, I have friends, you know? Oh my heavens, I have more straight friends than gay friends. Who cares, you know?
Exactly. Exactly. So, you know, it makes me sort of sit back and scratch my bald spot on the back of my head and and think.
Well,
you know,
if you think about this, then this is one of the things that those of us in this community can really do to rise above, and that is stop labeling ourselves, stop labeling other people. You know, I understand, and I'm very proud to be gay, because this is how I was made. But to be honest with you, I don't label myself as a lesbian or a gay woman. I am Regina. I am interested in achieving the greatest level that I possibly can of love and compassion and peace for everybody on the planet. So I lead with the part of me that doesn't see you as a white gay male. I see into your heart. And I think that that's when we do that, then we really are able to be an example for other people. That's what Christians want to do, but they don't do it because they're looking at the labels. you know, my gay lifestyle, I'm lesbian, whatever. They don't even get past that, Robert. You know, they don't get past someone being black or white or disabled or whatever. Look inside someone, and when we start doing that as a gay lesbian community, then I tell you what, we will lead the way and show them what's right.
You know what? You just nailed it, Regina. I mean, think of it. Ladies and gentlemen, talking about somebody that is so outspoken and so well-versed in her beliefs, that's our guest today. We can look at what's been going on in, what is it, South Carolina? Is it not South Carolina? The issue with the flag, the Confederate flag, and for the racism of which that it stands, okay?
Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm. And, people have said, well, let's take the flag down because that is disruptive. Let's finally take it down. 150 freaking years after the Civil War was won, the flag finally came down.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
So what is it with, and let's generalize the South versus everywhere else in the Union. They say that the South is the Bible Belt, okay, and maybe Arkansas.
My sister lives there.
Maybe it's the belt buckle. If that's the case, do you think that somebody just pantsed the South?
Did what? I'm sorry, I didn't hear you, Robert.
Do you think that maybe somebody just pantsed the South?
I don't know. You know, there's so many good people all around the world, so that, again, to me is a label, and it's one that I really try to stay away from. I really work hard for us, Robert, to lead with our heart, and I tell you what, anybody who's against taking that flag down is not, and forgive me, with all due respect, you're not thinking with your heart about what it feels like to be in someone's position that symbol would be upsetting. So when we start leading with that part of us, the part of us that is bigger and wiser and kinder than our ego that tells us that we can have that up there because of whatever stupid reason,
right,
then we're going to start changing a lot of these things. That's the ticket, Robert, and that's what gay, straight, lesbian, whatever, it doesn't matter. We've all got to lead with that part of us so that we no longer do things that hurt one another, that no longer box one another.
Well, realistically, I look at our nation as a whole, and I say, you know what has hurt America beyond anything else, even including the issue of gay marriage or gay rights or civil rights, any of those things, right, that can be construed to say, okay, well, these rights have really devastated our nation. Not so much, because I look at it and think, wait a second, the actual abuse that I find more and more Americans and more people globally that are suffering abuse at or as a direct result of is because of the religious morons.
I think that fear and the religious persecution of people is one aspect of it too. I do believe that very much, Robert, and that's why I think that on a global scale that we're having a transition. I see a shift. I see a shift for a lot of people looking for something that is beyond the box, you know.
Wow.
Ancient religions,
right,
Texts written in a time that is light years from today. You know, scholars have told us that we cannot believe those verses in the Bible about homosexuality because, first of all, you've got to understand that when one group went in and one army went in and took care of the other army, then the men would rape the men, and that's where that verse comes from. So there's so many different things that people just don't generally know about these particular verses. A lot of stuff in the Bible. So I think clinging to any kind of ancient text to guide us in a modern era is absolutely misguided, and yet this is going to have to come from within, Robert. You know, these kind of things are changing, and they're going to have to change. And I think that the young people today, you know, I'm 58 years old, I don't know how old you are, but I can guarantee you that the young people today are thinking, no, wait a minute, this is not right, and we don't want to continue these kinds of abusive, judgmental beliefs because it doesn't feel right. That's why they're not going to the old churches. You know, they're not being brainwashed in the exact same way that you and I were brainwashed. I was a rebel. You know, at 3 years old, I said, no, wait a minute. This isn't going to work for me. Y'all have got it wrong. You know, my life is going to be devoted to actually undoing whatever it is that you're trying to do.
You know, and it takes often when young children, and if you are a parent at home, you're a grandparent, listen to this, all right? Because it takes a, when you start abusing a child and teaching a child something that is so ludicrous, so ridiculous to begin with, and you continue to brainwash, browbeat children, guess what? It takes them a lifetime, perhaps the rest of their life, to actually overcome the obstacles that you, by your own diligence, maybe your own negligence, maybe by your own faith or your own commitment to what humanity should be all about, but you have denied them the privilege of finding out those things on their own. But
that's
the damage that is done, Regina, the damage inside of people's hearts.
I know, sweetie. I know.
You know, ladies and gentlemen, this is the Robert Christian Show. We are going to take a short break. And yes, we're going to be coming back with our featured guest, Regina Cates. And we're going to be talking a little bit about her book also, and where you can get it, Amazon or Barnes & Noble, various other places. So we're going to be continuing, folks, visiting with Regina. When we return, don't go away.
Sure. Fine.
Yeah.
I like that one.
Live from Washington, the Robert Christian Show. Online at robertchristianshow.com. Stay tuned with our featured guest, Regina Cates.
That's fine. I'm here. Not going anywhere. I'm gonna kick me off.
More than what you imagined, the Robert Christian Show, and we are on the air. And guess what, ladies and gentlemen? We have a very special guest, a powerful guest in her own right. She is the author of the book, Lead With Your Heart. It is on Amazon.com, Barnes & Noble, and various other places that you can find out more about her book, and please do so. And if, I guess, hey, I'll put this plug out there, Regina. If folks want to follow you on Facebook, they can do so. Hey, I just did it. I just sent her a message.
Excellent. Look at that later, Robert.
Regina Cates. Yes, yes, yes. So, yeah, she's on Facebook. She's on Twitter. Yeah, you're on Twitter, right?
Yeah, Romancing Your Soul on Facebook, Romance Your Soul on Twitter.
And for me, just type in the word, go to Google, gaggle this up, and type in MUD, M-U-D. And go to images, and there you'll find my picture. No, I'm just kidding. Anything but late for dinner. Okay, Regina. Wow. You know, people romance, as you know, a lot of things that are very harmful and very hurtful, and they hold on to these things in their life. And talking about, you know, Dr. Simon, I love the guy. Dr. Simon, he does a show here on the Diversity Network, but he does a show entitled The Skaya Show, and he talks about often the awakening and how that people are waking up. Do you feel that people in the LGBTI community, that they are waking up, or do you think that their vision has been under tow, and maybe now people are getting a hold of that message?
You know, Robert, I think that whether we're gay, straight, or anything, that we have an opportunity to wake up, so to speak. And what I mean by waking up is very clear to me, is that we decide that we're part of something greater than ourselves. You know, we're not just an individual person. We are part of the whole, and we begin to take responsibility for ourselves, our thoughts, our words, our actions, and how we contribute to the overall good to make the planet a better place. So having a feeling, a touch that you're part of something and you're a very important part of something, I think is very important for all of us to do, whether we're gay, straight, or anything like that. That's what the awakening is, you know? It's being authentic, okay? If I'm gay, then I'm authentically gay, it's okay. I'm owning that, I'm taking care of it. Not all people can come out, Robert, I understand that. Hopefully someday everybody will and be accepted. But I'm in a position where I can do that. But being authentic in your life, in every way that you possibly can, is the awakening part. Everything else comes from that, I truly believe.
So, in your own life, Regina, how have you been accepted? I mean, of course, we can look back at when we were little kids, and I'm telling you, you know, we grew up in the same generation. I'm 29. Shh.
Yeah, exactly.
But, you know, we grew up in the same generation, but I think that as far as the United States is concerned, that its understanding of gay and lesbian Americans is now unsurpassed based on what it used to be.
Certainly.
Thinking in the box.
Absolutely, and we have a lot of wonderful people. All of our ancestors that went before us, we need to say thank you very much. From those people that started in, you know, San Francisco to New York to everything that happened many, many years ago when you and I were just small children. I think it's very important. But we also have celebrities out there that are now open and out and gay, and that gives us a really good role model for young people. It's being talked about. Robert, when we grew up, it wasn't being talked about. In fact, I was one of those poor little children that this has been my battle to overcome the burdens of being gay. For many years, I thought I was the only gay person on the planet until I went off to college. I knew I was doomed to go to hell, so I was locked up in a psychiatric unit for being gay. I was sexually molested by a physician because it was going to make me straight. I've experienced a lot of things that hopefully young people today don't do because we've learned a little bit more about what it's like to be gay. I'm gay, just like you're white. I'm white. Other people are black. It's biological.
Well, do you think that there would be any chance for any of these? This is a ridiculous question, but a good one. But do you think that there'd be a chance this side of hell and back for some of these therapy? What do they call these places?
Conversion
therapy centers. Right. Do you think that they work?
No, they do not, actually, no, because, you know, I'm biologically gay, just like you're biologically gay, although it's not something I chose, because why would I do that, Robert? Why would I choose to grow up in an environment that hated me and still does to this day? This is not something that I chose. It's the air that I breathe. This is part of who I am. So I think that there are people that live a lie, but I do not think that anybody can be purposefully change through that. There are places that rape women continuously so that they will become straight. You know, these are moronic practices, Robert, and they're all based on fear, and they're all based on control, and they're all based on ignorance about what being gay, what being transgendered is all about.
So the bottom line is a fear of breaking out of the box.
A fear of accepting other people, especially when that book that's written so many years ago says in those six verses, Robert, okay, six, all right, out of the millions of verses in the Bible, or a million verses in the Bible, there are six of them that talk about homosexuality. And as we talked about before the show, there's a whole lot to talk about everything else, but this is what some of these people focus on. And it's just ludicrous today when scientific evidence, proves the fact. The world was thought one time to be flat, too, Robert, you know? Wow. At
sure.
One time, we thought that our universe was it, right? Wow. Okay, so everything changes and everything grows. And those people who want to find true happiness, true peace, true acceptance of themselves and others will look outside of what they're being told on this narrow vision. They're being spoon-fed a lie, Robert. It's all based on fear and control.
Well, what would you say on the other side of the coin if somebody said, well, the baseline for homosexuality is lust?
Well, I think the baseline for heterosexuality is lust, okay?
Sure. I mean, you know, the fact of it is that people are so afraid, Regina, to look beyond the box that they're standing in.
Robert, that's what I was talking about before, and that is that you and I are only able to change who we are. We're only able to be an example of what the best life looks like, whether we're gay or straight. You and I are not going to browbeat anybody who is a fundamentalist Christian who thinks that I'm going to go to hell. Fine, that's great, I will see you there, or whatever. But, you know, we're not going to be able to change that by being rude and obnoxious and nasty. The only thing that you and I can do is really light a candle to show the way of what it looks like to be the best person possible. Gay, straight, whatever, doesn't matter. Those people will either wake up to the fact that they're on the right path because it doesn't feel right to their heart, or they will continue to do whatever it is. And by the way, Robert, they're already living in hell.
Sure. Oh, absolutely. You know, I think that that more and more people, though, Regina, are literally living in hell because, you know, they would prefer to live their life in fear. And
well,
base
I think
that
it's
fear,
an addiction. Robert, fear is an addiction. You know, it changes
sure.
our body.
Yes,
and
it does.
And someone has to literally learn. It's like any other habit that we have. I smoked cigarettes for 22 years. I put that down. But it was an addiction, and I had to replace that addiction with a new positive habit. Our whole society thinks negatively. Opinionated commentary through the news. Opinion is not fact. We can look it up in the dictionary. You know, it's based on the grounds that's insufficient to produce a positive outcome or a factual outcome. So we're constantly bombarded by the negative, we're constantly bombarded by opinion, and we're not told to go within to listen for the answer. So the answer is for you and I to change ourselves and be the example for others, and to have a voice, and to counter, and to challenge these people by just bringing out what we believe the truth to be based upon evidence, based upon facts, based upon just I'm creating a better life.
You know, Regina, people, we need to wake up. People need to wake up. And rather than, again, rather than saying, oh, this is my gay son, my gay or lesbian sister, forget that noise. They are people.
That's right. You know, I have to tell you something, Robert. Like I told you, I just got back from the South, and I went to Sunday school with my mom and dad, and I had to listen to this hate-filled woman. But I want to tell you how my mother, who's 90 years old, introduced me to the Sunday school class. My mother introduces me as her beautiful daughter. My mother was so fear-based that she was going to lose all of her friends when I came out. She told me it was something that I learned. She told me that, and my father told me I was a business risk. They sent me to a physician who molested me. They put me in a mental institution. These people have changed 180 degrees. You know why? Because they actually questioned how they could continue to believe this about someone that they know to be a good person. And that's why she doesn't say I'm gay. She doesn't introduce my partner as her gay partner. She just says, this is Regina, this is Barbara, these are my beloveds. You know, that's the power of love, Robert, to change someone who was indoctrinated to believe exactly what we're talking about today. 90 years old, Robert. If she can do it, these younger people can do it. My father did it too.
You know, I agree. And to your parents, I congratulate them. I salute them.
They're heroes. They're superheroes. They're brave people, Robert.
You know, there is simply not enough people. You know, I've said for a long time, and I've made people quite upset, when I would say I want around me movers and shakers. People that are so outgoing, so passionate, that everywhere that they go, they touch people in places and their life is never the same again. And when somebody touches your heart, somebody pulls at your heart, an idea comes to mind and somebody else comes up behind you and they water it. And then suddenly then you start seeing this dream or this idea happen and come to reality. You know, the reality is of it, we're all of us are but mere human beings. So why should we stand in judgment of another?
Well, I'm going to disagree with you on that, Robert, because I believe we're spiritual beings on great human adventures, okay? Because the part of us that lives beyond our death, is much bigger. The human body is a part of who we are, and we navigate through this. This isn't religious. This is actually through my lifetime of connecting with something that's greater than myself. So whenever anybody I work with says, well, I'm just a human being, it's like, no, you're not, or else I wouldn't be here today. I wouldn't have quit smoking. I wouldn't have lost 63 pounds. I wouldn't love those people that hate me if I was just a human being with an ego. I've risen above that, Robert. I've worked my ass off to do it. So I am in the business of saying, hey, you're much more than the label that you just put on yourself.
You know, to that I agree. To that I do agree. We are. So here is the most difficult million-dollar question. Why do people do it?
Why do people do what, sweetie?
Why do people judge and hate and live in fear and in torment when they don't have to do that?
Because I think that our global society at this particular point in time is more adversarial. It is one of those where it's us against them. And that's fear-based. If I don't get mine first, someone's going to take it from me. You know where this comes from, Robert? Forgive me, but the media. It comes from what we watch on television. It comes from opinionated commentary. It comes from those people not really wanting to find a connection to something greater than themselves. They want to be spoon-fed all of this propaganda BS.
Yeah, you know, it's funny that you bring that up, because in the second hour of today's show, we're going to be talking about what is so wrong with mainstream media. And one of the things that I can say straight away is that mainstream media, they do not pay. And I used to work in it. They don't pay attention to news stories that are really good news stories unless they are sellable. Unless they can get the big-time sponsors behind it, unless they get big-time dollars, or it is an absolute sensational story, then...
And how do we change that, Robert?
Say again?
How do we change that?
That's the whole thing. Well, you know, more and more people, though, they're cutting the cord of cable television, and more people are going online to get their news, to get their independent media, to get their... They find broadcasts. They find shows like this one. They find shows like The Sky Show and others. And so, you know, I'm going to support this. This is way better idea.
That's true. And how do we fix politics in America, Robert? The same way we take money out of it.
That's exactly right. We have to take money out of it.
Yeah, we have to take money out of it, you know. We have to be able to actually work for the people. And the only person that's going to do that is not an attorney. We've got to get rid of all the attorneys in Washington, too, because when you get a bunch of them in the room, we have Congress, and this is what we have. So we, the people, are the government of the United States. We, the people, need to say, wait a minute, this has got to change. And that's why I was so proud of Marianne Williamson for standing up and saying, hey, listen, we got to take money out of politics. I'm going to run. I'm going to do what I can to enlighten Washington. Here's the problem. You and I have to enlighten Washington as to what we want.
That's right.
Because they're going to continue to tell us and sell us exactly what they think we want, and we're all going bankrupt. We don't have health care. You know, we don't have so many other things that we really need to have as a country as great as ours. As long as we're being run by major companies, we got to take money out of it. We can no longer allow someone to be able to buy us.
Well, money has bought politics in Washington for years.
Sure. We got to change that. It's the same with receiving news. It's all about advertisement. And it's all about whoever has the money to do that. That's why you and I, as the consumer, Robert, the only thing that we can do is that we can tune into channels that will give us Gwen Ifill, Washington Week in Review. Channels on PBS and channels on other people's stations that are not motivated by the bottom line.
You know, you're right, and this is a good, well, sort of a plug, I guess, if there is a plug for it. I don't know. But for those that enjoy public access television on their cable networks, the public access TVs, they can watch independent shows, movies, presentations, talk shows, cooking shows, all of this stuff. And guess what? Their bottom line is not the almighty dollar based on commercial advertising.
That's correct. Yeah, I love those shows. You know why, Robert? Because I learn from them, and I'm becoming a better human being and a better spiritual being and a better person.
Sure. I mean, you know, there's if you think of the small handful of reasonable TV shows or news type shows, reasonable amount, just a very small fraction that is actually on mainstream media. All right. Progressive. All right. If you're progressive, if you're right wing, okay. If you're left wing, it's very, very few. The limits are so constrained. But when you bust out of that box, you break down the closet door and you look online, you see what is actually out there. It is absolutely amazing.
It is amazing, and of course we have to do due diligence, and we have to make sure that we don't watch certain things because everybody's got an opinion, and they're like, you know, that phrase that we can say again, opinion is not fact. We need to look for those people who are interested in delivering facts as they know them, as facts as they can figure them out. And then us, we have to be educated enough to determine, does this feel right to us? Does this make sense for everybody involved, not just a small number of people? So here's the bottom line for me, Robert, and this is what I do every day through my book, podcast, through videos, through whatever I can get out there, through wonderful opportunities like to be with you today. This is all about personal empowerment, Robert. We are on this journey. We live with other people, but our goal is to be the best person that we can possibly be, the best educated. Doesn't mean a formal education, Robert. It means that we can be educated through the internet, but we can no longer just sit there and have sitcoms feed us, okay?
That's right.
What kind of children are we going to raise watching, you know, Real Housewives of Anywhere, okay? That's not real life. We have to really care about making a difference and making a life for ourselves outside of everything that we hear. And my life is a testament to what a great life that we can have. You know, I'm not wealthy, I'm not famous, I'm not any of that, but I'm happy, I'm peaceful, I'm joyful, and I am creating a legacy that is doing something to better the planet. And when each of us chooses to do this, like you are, like I am, I tell you what, kiddo, we're helping to change the world.
Well, you know? Regina, I've had people, some well-known people, say, oh my God, an hour interview, that is an awful long time. And really, it's not.
I'm just getting started.
You got that right. So, Regina, I hate to jump ship, but I must, because I've got to get into your book a little bit. The title of it is Lead With Your Heart. You said people can get it on Amazon, Barnes & Noble. Tell us a bit about your book.
Well, it's a 10-year labor of love, Robert. It is actually how I took my journey back from being a gay woman raised in the South and knowing once I was a little child. It's also the book that I wrote that I didn't have that allows me to take daily steps to connect with that divine part of us. So it's Lead With Your Heart, Creating a Life of Love, Compassion, and Purpose. It's endorsed by a whole lot of people in this industry, and I'm just blessed. It's available all over the world, certainly on Amazon. And what I wrote it for, Robert, is that it really does help people in the privacy of their own home take charge of their life. They don't need to do much more than just begin to think about it by reading this particular book. Yeah.
I think it's incredible, and I would love to be able to get that copy of that myself.
Sure.
Read it, maybe send that to my own mother. You know, life is so much more, Regina, than what people think that it is.
Yeah, why are we here, Robert? One question I'm going to ask you, why are we here?
Why are we here? We are here to change the world.
We are, but how do we do that?
Let me jump right in. We do it one person at a time. That's how we
who
do
we
it.
Who do we start with?
Ourselves.
Perfect. That's what this book is all about. It's me. I started with me. This is the man in the mirror. You know, Michael would like it if he was still alive. I can guarantee you that. But it's about the relationships that we have, Robert. We're here for the relationships. And if we don't have a good relationship with ourselves first, then we can't have good relationships with everyone else. So the key to everything that we're dealing with on the planet today starts with us. Because when you and I have a really good, respectful, kind, compassionate, forgiving, understanding, open relationship with ourselves, we're going to have that with other people.
Regina, I do absolutely agree, and I would love to have you back on a future show.
I will be here.
You are so on top of things. And, you know, it's like I said before, folks, you know, you guys missed what we were actually talking about prior to the show. But we were talking, and I told her, I said, you know, it's sort of, Regina, sort of like kindred spirits. Because, I mean, I feel exactly where she is. And I think that she feels exactly where I am. But there is, she has a goal. She has a message that she wants to be able to share and to present with the world. And it, whatever the people walk away with that with, I mean, I hope that it is something good, something life-changing and life-challenging. Because then for Regina, I guess I can say it would be well worth it.
Oh, isn't it amazing when we can share our heart, Robert, and then people say, wow, you know, I was thinking about that too. And if you can do it, I can do it. I mean, there's nothing that gets better than that, Robert. Nothing.
You're right. You're right. And you know, I think, though, that your book is going to be a success, but more so your vision, your voice, Regina. You're as clear as a bell. If people would just clean out their ears a little bit, you see what I mean.
Well, I just speak from my heart, Robert. I really do. And my motivation for everything that I do is to help people love and be loved. That's the whole reason for my existence, because I wasn't loved and I did not love. And now I do. Even those people that hate me, I love them. And I think that's what Jesus wanted us to do. I think that's what every great spiritual teacher has ever guided us to do. And that's why I know that we really are spiritual beings on a human adventure.
We definitely are. You know, none of us, none of us know the at the end of the day what's going to happen, right? But we can all look forward to the end of the day when we can all finally relax and rest and be ourselves.
You know what? And that's in every single moment, sweetie. That's right this second. We can take it right this second. I'm not waiting until 5 o'clock.
Right. You're right. Hey, Regina, what is your website address if people wanted to go to your website and find you?
Sure. Everything is available through romancingyoursoul.com or reginacates.com.
Now I need some graphics that I have hearts going everywhere. Romancing.
Right.
Ooh.
Yeah.
You're right on. Well, Regina, you know, it has been an absolute honor to be able to have you on, and we need to do it again, because you are a very deep person, and you're rooted in something that not that many people are rooted in.
Well, I don't feel that I'm special, Robert. You know, it's been an honor to be with you today. I love talking about this, and I will join you at any time, but I'm not special. I am just someone who decides to walk in love. That's it.
Well, you know what? It pours from the pores in your skin. It comes out, and that's lovely. Well, listen, I won't keep you too long here tonight, but do give your partner our best, and I will send you a link to today's video up on YouTube. Woohoo! Sometime great. Later on this evening.
All right, great. Thank you.
All right, thanks so very much, Regina, for joining us. Ladies and gentlemen, Regina Cates. Wow, what a cool interview. Fantastic interview. And ladies and gentlemen, don't go too far, because when we return, we will, we have, of course, more news that we're going to be talking about, and the evilness, oh, God, the mainstream media. Let's make fun of it.
Thank you, sir. I'm going to say good night. I'll be in touch. Thank you, Robert. All right. Bye.
Live from Seattle, The Robert Christian Show.
You're watching The Robert Christian Show. We'll be right back. Stay tuned.
Ladies and gentlemen, and it is a joy having everybody aboard today. Of course, we have far more that we're going to be talking about and diving into. You betcha. Let your family, your friends, your neighbors know that the Robert Christian Show is on the air. And of course, on the web, robertchristianshow.com. Live in Seattle, the Robert Christian Show, and greetings everyone from around the world, wherever that you are. Once again, a special thank you to our featured guest, Regina Cates.